January 12th marks the 10th anniversary of the devastating earthquake in Haiti that affected so many lives. But I'm going to tell you a little bit about what I saw and what I experienced in Haiti over the last few months. I arrived in Haiti in mid-September, which is about the time that the latest round of protests erupted. These protests are driven by underlying economic causes, political challenges, civil society's resentment of corruption in the country. And the reality is that manifests in barricades on the roads, protests on the streets, and violence. The goal of Pays Lux, which literally means country blocked, was really to shut down the country and force the president to leave. That was the objective of these protests. But the consequences of those protests are quite wide felt. And for me, the most important consequence is economic. So many large companies have fired large percentages of their workforce. The informal economy virtually shut down. And what we see is that households are having a hard time making the choice about whether they'll go to the hospital or not because they know they have to pay. And I think it's really important to acknowledge that hospitals, whether they're public or private, they don't have enough funding to be able to provide free care as MSF does. I can't emphasize enough how difficult it's been in this period for basic, for the basic functioning of hospitals. So throughout it, there were crises for individual things like fuel, oxygen, and other basic medical supplies. But every day, patients need to pay for the very basic supplies that are used to treat them, including gloves and sutures and drugs and other essential ingredients. MSF opened its very first trauma hospital in Haiti in 2004. And I think the thing that makes me saddest today is the fact that here we are going into 2020. We open a new trauma hospital and we see 60% of our cases are gunshot wounds. So irrespective of what's happening in the political and economic crisis, we know today there are many, many people that are affected by personally and deeply by the violence that exists in the city. It's been a pretty incredible few months for MSF, trying in this difficult context to expand our activities. The opening of the Tabar Trauma Hospital was a big challenge, right? It was hard to move trucks on the road. We had to move supplies in. It was hard to recruit staff. So as a sign of the economic crisis, we received more than 37,000 applications for about 300 jobs. We've been open for just a couple of weeks now, and even in our first week, we had more patients than we expected to see in an average week for our plans for 2020. Amongst the patients we received, 60% are gunshot wounds, 10% are other violent trauma, and the rest are the kinds of things that happen when you have roadside accidents, so open fractures. But when I look forward at what Haiti needs today, for me it's really clear that there's a vast array of other health needs that are not being responded to. And so I think that my big complaint for the world is that nobody's paying attention. And the people of Haiti need us to pay attention.